the European Cup afloat on such a sea of troubles as Leeds United. Only 4 points from the first 7 league games. They've played 7 league games, 1 charity shield game and a League Cup match, and have yet to score more than 1 goal in any match. The loss of Don Revie to England, the loss of the suspended Billy Bremner, and the remarkable events of the 42 days reign of Brian Clough and his dramatic dismissal have upset the club and its supporters greatly. Assistant manager Maurice Lindley and chief coach Sid Owen are in charge, and Mr. Lindley said today that it's back to square one at Elland Road. That's the Leeds United side, and Paul Reaney at number 2 had a special presentation just before the game. A loud burst of applause as Manny Cousins, the Leeds chairman, came out and presented an inscribed silver plate to Paul Reaney to commemorate those 600 games. And there's Paul waving to the crowd and acknowledging the cheers of the Leeds United faithful. FC Zurich, the Swiss part-timers, including in their ranks a male model, a plasterer, a printer and a garage owner. They lost only one of 26 games in winning the Swiss Championship last year, with a goal average of 65 against 20. They have 9 internationals there, one of them a Yugoslavian, Katic. 5 of them played in the Swiss team beaten 2-1 by West Germany recently. Their captain is Jakob Kuhn, and their star is René Bontenon, the 19-year-old number 11, whom Ajax of Amsterdam want badly. The referee, in fact, all 3 officials come from Holland. The referee is a late change. He's Mr. John Kaiser. The linesmen, Mr. Ram and Mr. Dreisma. There's the crowd hoping that tonight Leeds United can get really out of the trough, score more than 1 goal in a match, and bring back the great days of last season. They've been pretty depressed recently. They want the light to shine for them tonight. So Leeds United, whose great ambition is to win the European Cup with this side, which has won almost every other honour but the European Cup. They can't do it with Don Revie this year. They have to start in this first round without a manager. Leeds United in the all-white strip, FC Zurich playing in an all-red strip. The red-shirted part-timers of FC Zurich, although they're part-timers, the best players can earn up to £4,000 a year from football in addition to their jobs. But here, Leeds United on the attack with Lorimer. 3 defenders converging on Lorimer, and a free kick awarded to Leeds United. Giles. Johnny Giles having the shot, the man who would have liked the Leeds United manager's job but resigned when the directors were lukewarm. Botteron. This René Botteron putting it back to Carl Grobe. That's the golden boy that Ajax will pay a lot of money for. Jean de Peu. Jean Dupeu. Hare. Again Jean Dupeu. Martinelli. Stierli. Botteron. Kuhn. That's quite a dig from all of 45 yards from Kuhn, the skipper. Clark, Giles, Lorimer, up for Jordan. Joe Jordan chasing. The man who lost his place under the Clough regime to John O'Hare. This is Carl Grove. A plasterer by profession. Joris. Kuhn, the man who went in on him. This is Bionda. Martinelli. This is the male model. Italian extraction. Rutschmann. linesman raising his flag. Throw to FC Zurich. Kuhn. Giles. Clark. Cooper. McQueen. Deflection almost found Rini. Bottrom. Beyonder. Stierle. Interception by Giles. Good shot by Giles, but just wide. Lot of power behind it. John Giles using his right foot and 2 or 3 yards wide, but a lot of power. Here we see it. John Giles deciding to have a go from 35 yards. Hits it with his right foot. A lot of power, but wide. Hunter. Flicked on by Martinelli. McQueen. Giles. That touched Rutschman. Cooper. Down for Lorimer. It was jostled by Stierle. Hunter. Giles. Rini. Martinelli took his life in his hands then. Martinelli chasing up Jean Dupeur. That's a good ball to him. McQueen's there with him. Jean Dupeur trying to get it through the legs of McQueen and chasing after Rini. And a ball ring. Giles. Cooper. Rini. The last Leeds man to make the 600 landmark was Jack Charlton, but now here's Cooper. Beyonder got in the way of that. Now Madeley. Again the deflection. Jordan Clark. Jordan, goal! How did Clark do it? How did Clark find a way through that massive leg? Let's see how this happened. The deflection. It's Clark and Jordan who are there. That's Jordan's header. Now here's Clark with his back to the goal and defenders with him at the goal. Out goes the toe and it's in. Alan Clark's fourth goal of the season in the 13th minute. Get the breakthrough. Martinelli, that struck McQueen. Picked up by Katis. Play on, says Mr. Kaiser. Clark. Cooper. Again from Hunter, now Giles. Leeds of scented blood. They're looking for that second goal. That was Giles. McQueen got up between two. Swadley. Lorimer found a space for himself. It's covered now. But at the end, it looks like a free kick to FC Zurich. Rutschman was the man who got back there, and Lorimer fouled him. Beyonder. Oh, Haven't seen much of the Zurich attack since the opening 5 minutes. Giles almost robbed. Cooper. Giles has Yonas on the outside. Giles being shadowed by Kuhn. Cooper going in. Finding Yonas. Giles. Jordan got a push from Bottrell. That's René Bottrell, who appeared to free kick been awarded for offside. The linesman putting his flag up. It's a free kick to FC Zurich. The linesman ruled offside. Here's the replay. Now watch Jordan go headlong. Giles. Cooper. Kick to Leeds. Rutschmann and Cooper having words. This is Cooper trying to take on Rutschmann. There's the free kick. McQueen is up and appealing, and yet another free kick, getting very untidy now. McQueen adjudged to have fouled Kuhn. Kuhn picking up Hunter's header. Stierli. Biondo. Martinelli pushing it out towards Katish. Katish Hare. Good running by Hare. Good fast running. Cooper tidying up for the second time. Well, there's no space. Hunter. Hunter tumbled. That's friendly enough. Max Herrera will be pleased that it was friendly. Giles, Cooper. Greening. Lorimer. Paul Madeley running down the middle. Again a bit of pushing. And this time it is awarded.